To deploy our application, first let's go to our Firebase console and let's look for hosting. You can click here and you're going to be taken to the Firebase hosting page. There you're going to click on the Get Started button. Let's just go through this, click Next. Next, they are explaining what you're going to do, but we'll see that in the video. And click Continue to console. Now Firebase Hosting is ready for you to use and they are waiting for your first release. So then we can go back into our application and open the terminal. And in here, you're going to type Firebase init hosting. It's going to ask you a few things, like first, are you going to use an existing project or create a new Firebase project? Since we already have our Firebase application, we're going to say use an existing project. The only one I have here is this one. That's the one I've been showing you as an example. So I'm going to click enter. And then it asks you about your build. It says, what do you want to use as your public directory? Here, we're going to type www because that's the default Angular is giving us. If you are not sure, you can go into the angular.json file. And inside of the build, you can see the output path. This one is www, so that's what I'm going to add there. Here I can click enter. Configure as a single page application. This will rewrite all URLs to index.html. We're going to say yes because Ionic Angular creates a single page application. Set up automatic builds and deploys with GitHub, not at this time. And it says, okay, you already have an index.html file. Do you want to override it? Let's say no. And Firebase initialization completed. So let's see what it created. When you go to the file explorer, you're going to see that it added a .firebase.rc file. And in here, it's only telling you, okay, this is the project that you are using. And then it added a firebase.json file. And this has only the hosting configuration because we are only deploying through Firebase hosting. It says, okay, the public directory is going to be the www folder. We are going to ignore the firebase.json file, and we are going to ignore the node modules, and everything is going to be rerouted through the index.html file. If you don't know why this is happening, you can open your index.html file, and you can see that everything that's coming through that file is going to get this app root. That app root is going to load the app component, and that app component has the Angular router. So everything will be handled through there. Once all of that is configured, we are going to open the terminal again. Once we have that set up, we are going to create a production build to deploy. For that, I'm going to use the Angular CLI typing ng build --prod. Okay, I had an issue during the build. So I noticed that here I actually went back to the app.module.file and notice that in here where I'm importing Angular Fire Messaging, I should actually be importing the Angular Fire Messaging module. And then go below in the imports array and you need to do the same. Then you can save. You can just close that file. And then you can run the ng build prod command again. Now that our build is ready, we can go back to the console, and in here we can use the Firebase CLI to deploy our application. You can say Firebase deploy, and this would deploy your entire application. But if you have other things here, like let's say Firebase security rules, cloud functions, and things like that, and you only want to deploy hosting, you can pass the only flag and type hosting. This way, the only thing that will be deployed is your Firebase hosting. Once that's done, you can go back here to your hosting console. Once you reload, you see that it no longer says waiting for a deploy, but says that the status is the current deploy, and that's today's date, and the user that did the deploy, and it says it has, let's see, 1,000 over 400 files. In here, you can add a custom domain to your application, or you can quickly test this with any of the domains we have. So for example, we click the first one, my first app.web.app, and you see that it's taking me to the application. And the first thing it's doing is asking me if I want to allow push notifications. And there we have our entire application as a PWA. Let's see, we can do inspect. Let's open this here a little bit more. And in Lighthouse, we can see, okay, let's generate a new report to see how our application is doing. And as you can see, it finished and it says that the application goes in over 93 for performance, it has accessibility, best practice, and we are lacking a little bit in SEO. We'll tackle that later. And it says that indeed this is a progressive web application. If we click here, we can see all of the tests that passed. It says, okay, it has a manifest and a service worker. Then it goes and says, okay, it has the start URL, it redirects to HTTPS. And it says that it does not provide a valid Apple Touch icon. So that's something that we can fix, and we can add that icon to the index file.